So this is what you want, beautiful Amazon labels printing out of your printer, but this is probably what you got. Jams, a mess, weird formats, giant labels, and that's what we're gonna be going over in this video. How to do this on a Windows computer. How's it going, everybody? My name's Eric, and in this video, I'm going to show you step-by-step how to print Amazon FBA SKU labels, the product labels, on your Windows computer using a thermal printer. This tutorial is specific to Windows. Windows 10 is what I'm gonna be using. But if you are interested in looking for a Mac tutorial, I do have one in the description. Make sure to check that out. Just so you know, this will work on any thermal printer. You are going to be needing to use Google Chrome, the browser. We're going to be using a Google Chrome extension that formats labels within the browser. And we're gonna be using a Rollo printer. But you can use any printer. It doesn't have to be a Rollo printer. I'm just using it for this video because a lot of people have them. And when we do the settings, you'll see exactly how it's done on a Rollo printer, but it's pretty much the same on any other printer. You're going to also need product SKU labels. These are 62 millimeter by 29 millimeter. A real popular size is 1 inch by 2 5/8. So if you have those, you might have to convert those to millimeters and then use them later on in the video. So you'll see that. If you haven't already, please give the video a thumbs up so more people can find it and solve their problem. And if you aren't already subscribed to the channel, consider subscribing. If you have a specific problem or tutorial you want seen done, please put it in the comment section below. Let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and let's get into the tutorial. So here we are on our Windows computer, and as I mentioned earlier, you are going to have to use Google Chrome because this entire workaround tutorial thing is based on a Google Chrome extension. You're going to have to go to Rollo's website and download a Rollo Chrome extension. I will put a link to this directly in the description. You have to download the Chrome extension, install the Chrome extension, and then you have to make an account. Rollo wants your information, they want your email, they want your contact. That's the name of the game. The extension's free, but you give up your information. So the next thing you're going to do is you're gonna go down here to your Finder window, you're gonna type in printers and scanners, you're gonna go to that system settings, you're gonna find whatever printer that you're using. In our case, we're using the Rollo printer. We're gonna go to manage, printing preferences, and you need to find the setting where you can do custom paper. This is very important. This is like the trick. If you mess this up, it's not going to work. The labels that I'm using, they are 62 millimeters by 29 millimeters. It defaulted to 100 by 210. I already changed my width to 62 by 29, and then I hit save, and it basically changed this, my custom paper, to 62 by 29. If you're using a different dimension, which you probably are, you're going to have to use different dimensions. The popular dimension is 1 inch by 2 5/8. So you could go to a millimeter, inches to millimeter converter calculator, any of them, and we're going to type in 1 inch. And that is 25.4 millimeters. So you would use that as your height if you were using the 1 inch. And then 2 5/8, we're gonna convert that. It's 66.6. So you could round up, I think, to probably 60, 67. 1 millimeter isn't gonna make that much of a difference. So you would put your width at 67, and you would put your height at, what was it, for 1 inch, 24 point something 25.4, if you're using those dimensions. Let's see what happens when I do a fraction. I guess it can save fractions. You can do the decimals if you want, but we're doing 62 by 29 is our label dimension. Yours could be different, but putting it in is what's important, the correct dimensions. We're going to hit apply, and we're going to hit OK. And that basically tells the computer, hey, we have this new dimensions that we can pick that we want to use when we're printing a type of label. Now we're going to go to Amazon.
You're going to want to make sure, if you haven't already, to calibrate your printer with the new smaller labels. Maybe you're using a printer that used 4x6 shipping labels in the past. You want to change those labels. You want to calibrate it. Usually it's by holding a button down, button combinations. You're just going to have to look that up with your specific printer model in order to calibrate your printer. Now you're going to pick this drop down. Whichever one is closest to what your label size are in millimeters, or in the case of 1x2 5/8, you could pick that one. Mine is this one. You're probably going to pick this one, but mine is this one. It's the closest to 62x29. It's 63.5x29.6. So we're going to hit that. Because we have our Rollo extension installed to Chrome, we're signed in. We can click right here to this little Rollo labels button. It's going to generate a file. You're going to open up that file, and that is your new format of your labels in order to print them on your thermal printer. It crops it for you based off of some code that Rollo wrote into their Chrome extension and allows it for individual label printing. Now, we're going to go up here to print. You're going to want to make sure that your correct printer is picked. The trick here is you need to pick the correct paper size. And in this case, it's the custom paper size. I don't know why it wouldn't let me change the name, but I'm just leaving it right here at 100x210. Just to make sure that we're not making a huge mistake trying to print 20 or 30 labels with the wrong dimensions, I'm gonna go up here to pages, gonna go to custom, and I'm just gonna print one as a test to make sure that it works. This could save you some time. It could save you some headache. We're gonna press print. And it kind of jammed. We're gonna do that one more time. This is troubleshoot. Control P. We're gonna do just one page. And we're going to hit print. Okay, there we go. Perfect. Now that we know that one is formatted correctly, we can safely print all of our labels. We know that our dimensions are right. Everything looks good. Everything's fitting on the label. And we can hit print. And it's just going to just chew those Amazon FBA labels up. We can take this. We can go label our products. And we're good to go. Just to recap, if you're having issues, I completely understand. I've been there. One setting off could throw everything off. You want to make sure you know your label dimensions. You want to make sure you create a custom label dimension setting in your printer. You're going to want to make sure your printer is calibrated, and then you're going to want to make sure that you pick those settings in your printer dialog. That should help everyone out there. Please let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, please give the video a thumbs up so more people can find it. Shout out to Rollo for creating this free extension. It is a great tool. Thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye.